Welcome to Pesticides, a video series from the National Pesticide Information Center. These are based on common pesticide questions from people just like you.
Hi, I'm Christina, a pesticide specialist with the National Pesticide Information Center, here to talk with you about methoprene. We'll discuss what it is, its toxicity to people and the environment, and finally, we'll talk about some ways that you can minimize the risk. The risk of having a problem because of a pesticide can vary depending on factors such as the toxicity of the chemical, how much we are exposed to, our route of exposure, and how sensitive we are. Therefore, all pesticides have some level of risk. With the following information, I hope you'll be able to weigh risks and benefits and make your own informed decision about the safety of methoprene. Methoprene is an insect growth regulator. It behaves like an important hormone in insects by interrupting their growth and development. It can be used against fleas, flies, moths, and beetles. In the case of this model, methoprene can prevent the flea from growing to become an adult. This prevents it from reproducing. Methoprene is found in over 500 pest control products. It is used in some foggers, mosquito control, flea treatments, and in cattle feed to control flies. When methoprene enters the environment, sunlight, microbes, and rain break it down quickly in soil, water, and in plants. Now that you know a little bit more about what methoprene is, let's discuss its toxicity to people. Methoprene can get into your body if you eat it, touch it, or breathe it in. Once in your body, most of methoprene is rapidly broken down, and the remaining bits leave the body. Methoprene can cause mild to moderate skin irritation. Brief exposures to methoprene can also cause slight irritation if they get into the eyes or the lungs. In studies where animals ate large doses of methoprene for long periods of time, they vomited, had dilated pupils, changes in behavior, and changes in breathing and body movements. In long-term animal studies, methoprene did not lead to the development of cancer. But what about other long-term effects? Some high-dose, long-term animal studies have shown effects on animal weight and the number of offspring. Other studies using the same dose or lower dose showed no effects. And what about children? Are they more at risk? While children may be more sensitive to pesticides, there are no studies showing that children are especially sensitive to methoprene. Now, let's continue on our path and look at the toxicity of methoprene to wildlife and fish. Methoprene is relatively non-toxic to birds. It's also low in toxicity to bees, although young bees may be more sensitive. It ranges from moderately to very highly toxic to fish and crustaceans. It also has the potential to accumulate in their tissue. Finally, let's discuss some ways that you can keep your risk low. Because with every pesticide application, there is a level of risk to both you and the environment, consider exhausting non-pesticide options first. These would be things like removing food, shelter, and water, and blocking entry points for pests. If you've decided to apply a product, follow the label instructions. Labels contain crucial information to reduce risk to you, your family, your pets, and the environment. You can take steps to minimize your risk before, during, and after a pesticide application. In an indoor application, consider letting surfaces dry before spending time indoors, and open up windows to ventilate. In the case of an outdoor application, like a fogging for mosquitoes, think about staying inside until the chemical has settled out of the air and dried on surfaces. Finally, to recap, methoprene is an insect growth regulator. It is low in toxicity to mammals, but high in toxicity to fish, and it breaks down quickly in the environment. Thanks for watching.
If you have questions about pesticides, please call us at 1-800-858-7378 or visit us on the web at npic.orst.edu. Pesticides are brought to you by the National Pesticide Information Center, a cooperative agreement between Oregon State University and the Environmental Protection Agency.